special live phone-in program webinar on ICT tool. And today's ICT tool is Educa Play. Well, what is Educa Play all about? The topic we are going to discuss is explore educational games using Educa Play. So, educational games, what exactly are those? Are they for studies? Are they for fun? There's a lot attached to them. If you have any questions to raise, please send it to us through our YouTube channel, which is NCERT Official. Write them down in the live chat box and share them with us. We have an expert with us and she'll be handling all those questions. She'll be explaining what is Educa Play all about and she'll be demonstrating as well. They'll show you that how can you use those games and you can gain knowledge from them. So if you have questions, like I said, you can even call us to raise your questions. The number is 8800 440 559. And if you want to mail us, the email ID is training@ciet.nic.in. So there are various mediums through which you can contact us and we'll be expecting your questions till 5 o'clock. So let me introduce our studio, our expert, our resource person to you, and she is Miss Sonia Vadva. Welcome, ma'am. So ma'am is the head of the technology integration from Nirmal Bhartiya School, Dwarka, New Delhi, and she is a lot more than this. I'll just introduce her a little bit more to all of you. She is a technology integration specialist. She is an academic leader, a passionate computer science facilitator for the last 24 years of experience in the field of educational technology only. She is a Microsoft trainer, a fellow, and innovative educator expert. So welcome to our program, ma'am, and thank you for being a part of this program.
Thank you, Tanviji, for that kind introduction. It's my honor to be here and share my little knowledge about the tool today.
So shall we begin talking about the tool, ma'am?
Yeah, definitely. Okay. So as audience, as ma'am, Tanviji has already mentioned the topic for today, that's exploring educational games using Educa Play, and we will also be creating. We will not only be exploring, so we will also be creating educational game during Educa using the tool Educa Play. I'm sure you must be wondering what this tool is all about. So this is a digital education platform, a very user-friendly educational game creator. Game and education, two words, we are trying to put them together from last now 5-10 years. So gamification of learning is a concept which the leaders in the education industry are talking about. Because if we can teach the way children wants to learn, or this generation wants to learn, then the learning outcomes can be taken to the next level. So gamification of learning is something we all are aware of, that it brings beautiful results in the classroom. So this is one beautiful platform that allows educators to create educational games. It's not only about creating new games, there are plethora of free resources which are ready to use. So you can either pick up a ready-to-use resource or a game, or you can create your own game. So when I say game, game means game-based activities. So we will see what kind of game-based activities we can create and what this platform has to offer for our learners. It provides a wide range of activities. So on next screen, I would show you the kind of activities it can create. So as I said, that you can either use a template and create an activity which is a ready to use template, or you can come up with absolutely creative new from your own thinking, through your own creation. Now see this beautiful screen. It talks about the kind of activity the tool has to offer: crossword puzzle, word search puzzle, ABC game, memory game, quizzing, match the following, fill in the blanks. Then you have riddle, video quiz, map quiz, unscramble words game, slideshows, dictation game, dialogue game, and there is much more. So when I say that all this can be created using one platform, I'm sure some of you in the room must be wondering that presently you must be using maybe, let's say, a different software that just offers you opportunity to conduct quizzes. And there is a platform that, like Edpuzzle, it allows you to conduct video-based assessment. We have a platform like Kahoot that allows us to conduct quizzes. But see the power of this tool. This particular tool gives you opportunity to do what you do on multiple platform, on a single platform. So the kind of activities for which I would go from 4 to 5 tools, EducaPlay offers me everything on a single platform. So I am sure you must be imagining the power of the tool. So it's a very, very powerful tool because it gives us an opportunity to conduct a plethora of activity using the same dashboard. Now, the next question comes to our mind: when it has so much to offer, is this tool a paid one? So the tool has a free version, which is absolutely free. We just have to sign up and create an account, and we can create all the activity. There's no limit that in the free account I can create 5 activity, or I can add 10 question, or I can have played 6 times, nothing like that. So I can, you know, it's a free tool. I can create all the activities that I need. There is no limitation. And I can, you know, just open an account quickly by using Google, Microsoft, Facebook, or any other email account, which we would soon see during the live demonstration. Now, the next question is, there exists a premium account feature also. So what is that is different, which is there in the premium account, but not in the free account? So the premium account is actually a little more in the sense that the software has certain ads in between. So I'll show you from the tools portal that what are the, you know, the different versions. And there is a nice table on the EducaPlay platform. If you go over there, the URL is educaplay.com. I will, you know, show you the login process, but I'm going to show you first the different versions that are available. So if I click on the premium tab here, so basic version is free, as I said, and they very clearly say that it will always be free. And if you're looking for extra features, what are those extra features? So for example, in the free version, you have certain ads. So the paid versions are ad free. There is no advertisement. And then you can, you know, there is a possibility of restricting in the paid version who can have access to your quizzes. So basically, you have various versions that allows you to give just. I am so sorry, there was some network problem. So I hope you can hear me now. So basically,
yes,
in the free version,
because we skipped certain portion, can you repeat that again?
Yeah, so I'm repeating that the problem, I was saying that this is a beautiful tool which is absolutely free, but since the tool offers a premium version, so if this question may come in the mind of our viewers, what is this paid version has to offer to us? So the paid version is absolutely advertisement free. That's the major advantage. So if you are okay with 1 or 2 ads that come in between the activity when children start playing, there is no need to think about going to the paid version. I've been using for years now the free version, so there is no problem. Second thing, if you want to integrate it within your school, you know, LMS, for example, if you're using Google Classroom or you are using Microsoft Teams or you are using, you know, LMS like Moodle, Blackboard, Canva, and you want to integrate this, but the activities that you conduct here within those platforms, you can actually go to the paid version. Otherwise, there is no need. Whatever premium version has to offer, that everything is there in the free version also. Now, coming back to the presentation, Tanviji, I hope I made it clear for our audience.
Yes, ma'am. Very much clear.
Okay. So at the end of the session that we are going to do today, you all will be able to create your own account on EducaPlay. My effort will be to highlight how to create an activity, how to share it with the audience, and how can we search and use the existing resources. So educators like you and me have also created plenty of resources which are already there. Mm-hmm. So I need not to reinvent the wheel. I may find some useful activity already existing and I can leverage them and share them. So this is our agenda for today's session. So I hope you are now ready for the live demo and I would take you to the tool. And then we will see how we can lock in and start our journey on EduPaPlay.
Okay. Ma'am, we are ready and excited.
Thank you. I'm too equally excited to introduce you and my audience to this tool. So this is basically the platform. The URL is www.educaplay.com. Mm-hmm. So once you type this, you land up to this page. And the very first line here is free educational games. And then it says create a free account. So if you are the first time user, you have to click on create a free account. If you already have an account, means once you come here for the second time, you have the login option. So as on other software also, we have sign up and sign in. Here we have login and we have create a free account. So I'm clicking here, create a free account. So once you click on create a free account, you can either use your Facebook or register with Google or register with Microsoft. If you do not want to give away your social media account details, because once you click here, you have to say that you have to give permission to connect your account with EduPaPlay. So if you are reluctant about that, you can, you know, directly go and type your details at the bottom. For example, I have a Rediff mail ID or I have a Hotmail ID or I have an ID like this. So I can write at the bottom, tick this, I'm not a robot. I have read and accept the terms and conditions. Terms and conditions says that if I'm a minor, then I need to log in using my parents' account. I need to have their permissions. And then I click here and I hit the sign up button. So once you do that, they will send you a verification mail on the email ID, which we have mentioned on the previous screen. So I am, I can go to this email ID and verify. But in the interest of time, I am showing you register with Google. So it's super easy. When we click on register with Google, we all have many Gmail accounts. So I'm picking a one Gmail account and then I'm doing the next, the same step. I'm authorizing the app to read my information and then I'm doing sign up. Now this is here I am in one simple step by signing in using Google. So if you have Microsoft account, do that. If you want to sign up using Facebook, that is also okay. Now talking about the dashboard. So once you come here, this is your dashboard. The left panel talks about, here is your profile picture, which you can change, then your name. It shows that the top left, the left band shows that which version I'm using. I'm using the free version. At any point of time, if I want, I can get premium. Now, this is my activity. If I click here, my activity, since I've created a new account, no activities here. Now, as the session progress and I'll be creating two or three activities, you would see they will come up under my activities. So I will come up to all these one by one. First, let's start creating a new activity because the fun is in creating games and games here are activities. So click on new activity and then I have the choice to create crossword puzzle, word search puzzle, ABC game, memory game. I can create quizzes. So let us start by creating the crossword puzzle. So I, in the interest of time, I will be showing you three or four creations. But this is all what is available for you to explore. It is super simple to create. And then you can create crossword puzzle. So you can create crossword puzzle here. And you can write the name of the, select the language first. Suppose I'm going to create an activity on internet, right? So I'm writing my topic here, internet. I'm writing the topic here, then I will write the description. So let me type the description here. So I'm writing my description here. So this is a crossword to test knowledge about internet. So I'm writing here, my topic, and then I have written here the title. Now it says select the knowledge area. In the knowledge area, I have to match it with the subject. So suppose I am writing here information and technology and communication. My audience age is, let's say, 12 years or 15 years. I can select it and then I can click on next. So this is what I am going to do on the first screen. If I'm not familiar with how to create an Educa Play, we have a supporting video that comes, so we can watch the video and do it. So since I am your coach for the day, and so you need not to watch this video, you can watch it at your leisure later on if you get stuck. So from where you will get this video again, by clicking this tutorial button. So you have a tutorial button here, which brings back the same video. So if you are new to this place and you want to learn how to create crossword puzzle, you can hit the tutorial button and the video will explain you step by step. So if there are 13, 14 activities that we can create, for every activity when you create it for the first time, you can leverage these videos. These are beautiful step-by-step explanation videos, and then we can actually create the stuff using our videos. Now the next thing here is, so I'm creating a crossword puzzle. So in the crossword puzzle, what do? We add words and all. So once you have defined your activity, so suppose this is a quiz on internet and I want to put an article, the internet, and I forgot about it. So I can anytime click on edit data. I can go here and modify my title. So suppose I write the internet. So I have done that, and then I can say send. It means once I was covering the, making the cover of the activity, whatever details I gave, I can edit that data and I can modify that. Now, if you want your crossword to have some time limit, click on edit. If you do not want time limit, let it be no. And if suppose I want my crossword should be attempted by my students in 5 or 20 seconds, or it is in seconds, make sure it is in seconds. So you give at least 1 minute. So I can write 60 seconds. If you want to give 2 minutes, you can write 120 seconds. If you do not want to give any limit, then let it be no. So I am writing here 120 seconds and saying send. It means this activity my children will have to complete in 2 minutes. Now, do you want the help buttons to be visible to your students while the activity is on? So what does the help button does? If I'm making it visible, and I show you during the demo that what is the role of help button. So I'm keeping it visible. So it's a crossword. So if suppose I'm not getting the first word, so if I get the first word, maybe it will hit me what is the answer. So the help buttons are like giving you one word or giving you 2 words of the crossword. Those kind of options can be made available. Now the major task is about adding the words. So let's start by adding the words. So I'm adding the first word. Let's say my first word is about the internet is network. So my first word is network. I will add my word. Now I need to give the definition. So based on my definition, the child would guess the word. And if this definition has to be textual, I will select the first radio button. And I'm writing here, internet is a, or maybe I'm writing it is used for sharing information and data. So I'm writing here, it is used for sharing information and data. So based on this, the user will guess the word network. Now this is text, then I say send. My one word is here. Now I'm adding another word. So remember, minimum 8 words has to be added to make a nice crossword. You can go up to 20, but 6 to 8 is what software is looking at. 8 is recommended, but below 6, if you do not have even 6, this publish activity button would be dim. So 6 is recommended, 8 is the ideal one, and 20 is what you can take up to. Now let's say my next word is intranet. Now suppose I don't want to type the clue, I want to record and say. So when the child click on the second option, my voice should come. So I can give a voice question also. So I can either upload an audio or I can record. So let me choose record. I have to give permission to your mic, my microphone, which I have already given, and say the question for this is, it is a network of devices within an organization. So I have recorded my question. The last option that you see on the screen, feedback, this is if related to this question, you want to share some extra information, like I'm writing, intranet is within an organization and internet is across the globe. So if suppose I want to give this additional information to my students, so I can put it over here, but this extra information would be available once the child will submit the activity, not before that. So I can then click on send. So two words I have added. Now I'm going to add the third word. So let me be a little faster. My third word is, let's say I want to add the word as cables, and I'm writing the text as special wires to connect computers. So I can give either the question as text or as audio, which I showed you, or I can upload an image. So I'm adding the fourth word. Now suppose I'm writing, if we can use it as a shared resource. So on a network, we can have a shared printer or a shared scanner. And let's say I want to upload the image of a scanner. So I say choose file. On my computer, I think I have an image of a scanner. So I would just go to the desktop and write here scanner and pick up the image. So this is the image that I have opened. And then I say send. So I've shown you the three ways of creating questions. So it is attempting. Four words have been created. Let me add quickly one or two more. And then suppose this is a quiz on internet. So I'm writing www. And here I am writing acronym for World Wide Web. So the software has the power of, grammar check, spell check also. The moment you go wrong, it will tell you your spelling mistakes also, and you can correct them. So I've added five words. I still don't have the option of publish activity. I'm adding one last word, which is URL. And then I'm giving the text question as address of a page on the internet. So six words I have now written. I'm hopeful that it will allow me to publish. So this is, let me add one more. And then I would write. So the last word that I'm going to write is maybe ISP, and I'm writing here, it is the service provider. So once you have added your questions to the, this crossword puzzle, you can preview your activity. So this preview word is now, option is now highlighted. Preview allows you to check how it would look to for your students while they will play. Okay. So it says one of the media file has not been uploaded correctly. So here I had used the audio file. So I'm going to go back to this question and remove it because it showed me that it did not upload. I would then create another question quickly. So I would add one more word here, and I would, that was for intranet. So I would write intranet, and this time I'm giving a text clue because uploading image file, audio file may take time. So I'm writing, it is network within organization. Now, once your questions are set, so I have sent this. Now I'm again clicking on preview. So my quiz is ready. The timer is here, 2 minutes. And let me make it full screen. It identified me as Sonia Wadhwa because I had already logged in. But if it will be students, the student can either join as anonymous or you can make them write their names also. So I would click on start. Now one, this is, if I click here one, it says this is device is coming. So I can click on one and I can start clicking on scanner because this was an image. Then I can click on next word, so scanner is fine. And then I can move on to the second option. For the second one, it is a network within an organization. So if I click on intranet, I can start writing. Then I go to third option. So third option is little this side. Okay, let me go to seventh first. So seventh, it is a service provider. I'm writing ISP. Then I'm going to this one. Sixth question, address of the URL. So I'm writing URL. Then my third question is, it is used for sharing data and information. So I'm writing here network. So my timer is running. I have to be mindful. Then I have, which is left, fourth one. I go here, special wires to connect. So then I'm writing the name of the wires. This is how my children will play. So I'm able to have a preview. So this fifth one is left. I come here, acronym for World Wide Web. So I press www. Now this is where I am stuck now, first one. So I need to, I think, correct this one. So my first start from here. I still have some seconds left. I can check. So my score is 90. There is something which I, one question which I have not attempted. I have made the spelling mistake for scanner. So I would just check. I would make it then correct. And then I can further click on check score. So because I am now exceeding the time. So once it is done, this is how my activity would come. If I wanted hint, I could have said show letter. So it would show me the letter. If I wanted full word to come, so I can click on full word. So I think instead of question, I have written answer one place. That's why it's coming. But this is how my activity would be conducted. So once you have done this, you can share the result on these platforms. And let me come back to my screen. So I have checked the preview. Now I can publish my activity. So once the preview is done, you can, if the publish activities option is not coming, it tells you the problem. So when people would look for this activity, I have to give few keywords. So first keyword, software itself has given information technology. Maybe my second would be internet. I will add this keyword. I need to give minimum 3 keywords for this activity to be published in the library. Why these keywords are important? Because if somebody searches an activity with these title, then these keywords help us to find out the existing activities. So I would click on publish activity. The moment I hit the publish activity, it says crossword generated successfully and the activity published. So my activity, my first activity is published. I come back to my profile by hitting my avatar. This is on the right hand side of the screen where it's written my Educa Play. Now see, my activity bank is not zero now. It has one activity which I have just created. So I have these options here. I can either download this activity, I can publish it to Google Classroom, I can use it to any, assign it to my student using any LMS. So when I say LMS, it can be Blackboard, Canva, read it. So you have multiple Moodle, you can connect it to multiple LMS. I can, suppose I'm showing you one example. If suppose my school uses Microsoft Teams and my students are on that platform, I can say publish to Microsoft Teams. Then I need to give permission and I would hit the button grant permission. And it will ask me to sign in using the Teams account which school is using. We will click on that account. We would give permission. And after that, we will be able to see all our classes in the Educa Play itself. So if suppose I teach 10 classes on Teams, all those classes will be visible right here. So these are my classes that I teach. Suppose I want to give this activity to this particular class. I click on my class and I say publish to Microsoft Teams. So my students will get this activity as an assignment. So this would go on Teams under the assignment section directly from this platform. So when we were seeing the, difference between the premium and free version, it was saying that integration of other platforms is, inbuilt in the premium version. But this is a way how you can do it in the free version. Now see the notification. I got a team notification here that an assignment has been assigned to this particular class using Educa Play. So directly the assignment has come for my students from the Educa Play 2D, so this is input output device assignment of EducaPlay. This is the internet assignment, and automatically the software has given a window of 1 week for the children to complete. If I want, I can edit the assignment and reduce the time window. So this assignment has already come in. These children will get a notification that teacher has set up this particular assignment for you. So see, the students are sitting online. Some of them have viewed also. I wonder they should not give a call that I have given them this assignment. So let's move ahead and see. Tanviji, any questions so far from the audience in the window, or we can move ahead?
Ma'am, let's take the questions towards the end of the session.
Sure, that's fine. So this is one activity which we have created. And I showed you the crossword puzzle activity. Then I showed you how I seamlessly assigned it to my students using the Microsoft Teams platform. The same level of convenience you would experience when you would assign this particular activity to your students using Google Classroom or any other LMS. So this is super, super easy. Okay. There is no rocket science. We have to just click on the button where we want to share. And the platform interface is very easy for anybody to try that.
Okay. Ma'am, one thing. So there are games and they are of certain information as well. So is there of any certain age that this standard students can play these kind of games? Because these days every game has the age limit. So is it assigned to these games as well?
Yeah, so ma'am, you must have observed while I was creating the activity.
Yes.
So I'll quickly show you while I was hitting the new activity button. Mm-hmm. And any of these activity, if I pick up, let's say whether it is a quiz or a memory game, it asks you to select audience age, right? So the audience age on this platform is going from 1 to 20. So basically from 3 to 20. So when I was creating any activity, I myself for my crossword puzzle gave the age as 12. So when you search the activity on this platform, so it basically shows you activity age wise. And as a teacher, we have the discretion to use. For example, I am searching an activity on this platform with the name photosynthesis. So when I'm myself creating, I'm specifying the age. Now when you select, so this is photosynthesis, it's given here. So there are multiple activities on photosynthesis. Now suppose I click on this photosynthesis and I go on the description, I would come to know that this particular activity recommended age 14 years old. Okay. So at the bottom of the activity, the age is coming. And how is it coming? Because while this person must have created, the software must have forced him to specify the age group. And similarly, when I am searching from the public library, I am also getting that this is recommended for this age group.
Okay, okay. So the parents and teachers will get to know that this is age appropriate or not.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. So the software itself is huge library. Now see, I just gave a topic photosynthesis, and you can see that it was not something which I pre-decided. I randomly gave that, and there are plenty of video assessment, match the column exercises, quiz exercise, crossword puzzle on photosynthesis already available here. So I can, you know, write here another topic also, and let's see, for example, I write another topic about climate or maybe, you know, pollution. So I can type any academic topic and I would see lot many activities are already there. This is one thing about, you know, searching by topic. There are another thing, you can search by type of activity. So suppose you are only looking for a video quizzes activity. So you can search by type of activity. You can search by activities which have got 5-star rating by the users. So you don't want a substandard activity. Some activities may be very basic. So you want standard activities, you can search by rating. You can search by area of knowledge, means subjects. And next thing is, you can, you know, if you want to clear filters and just search without any condition, you can do that as well. Another thing is searching by people. For example, while doing my search, I realized that this teacher from Spain, let's take this example, Alvinita, Alvinita is her username. She is very good and she creates all activities very nicely. So I can search by, instead of topic, I can search by her name also. So let me write her name, which was Alvanita. So if I write her name, these are all activities created by her. So I can search the activities by user also. So suppose here, let me try writing one more name. So these are the activity created by the people. So if suppose you know that you have a colleague who is a very good teacher, but you don't know her username, you can search her by name also on this platform and look for the activities that the person has created. Now the problem here is I'm having a free account. So whatever activities I would publish, they all will be public and they will come in this library. So that is what we have to give back to the society. They are giving us a free platform to use. Whatever we create, we are giving it back to society because all our creations are public. Other people can use it. Now, if suppose I am a, you know, education, I belong to an education institution. They want to keep their resources within the organization. They do not want to share it with the rest of the community. And they say that our educational resources are meant for our children and our staff. So it has to be accessible to only our staff with whom we share the link. It means the resource has to be unlisted or private and should not be available in the public library. So in the free version, I cannot control that. That is where in the premium version, it was written possibility of restricting access to your activity. So I don't have this option in the free version. Once I've created and published, it is available to all. But if I would have had the paid version, I could have controlled that only a selective students or a community from my school could see my resource and nobody else from outside. That is one limitation. But I think that limitation is beautiful because it allows us to collaborate, share, and use other experts' resources also. It gives us different perspectives. So we can actually use the existing resources created by other users. That's the beauty of it. Now, this was one aspect of this tool, which was creating new activity. Now, if you, I'm coming to my dashboard and showing you there is something called challenge. So if I create my challenge, what is challenge? So suppose you want to, you know, for a lesson, you have created four activities. And you want to put those activities in a group and want to give it to your class. So there is a match the following activity, there is a video lesson, there is a quiz, and you want to make it as a package of a challenge and give it to your class. Go to new challenge and there you tick on the activity. Since I have only one, I can create add that activity only. If I had many, so I could have added more activities. So presently I have added one activity. It says you can add any number of activities. So this very activity of mine, I have added. If I wanted, I could have added more activities. So in your package, you can enter 2, 3, 4 activities and you can create it as a challenge. So let me just, you know, go to this one and added activity. This is added. Now I say finish. I can add multiple activities also. So this has a game pin. So I am just copying this game pin. And I can, if suppose I was taking a live class, I could have put in it in the chat window and share it with my students. Now I'll show you how my students will have access to this game pin. On the home page, this says enter your game pin. So my students can access that game pin, which is given by me, and can enter the challenge. So they will be able to have this challenge played. See, the same quiz has come. I can start it. The point of the benefit of creating challenge over activities, activity is one single activity. While your challenge is a group of activities that you can create as a challenge and you can, you know, invite players to play it as a challenge. I can, you know, share the game pin. Now the beauty of game pin is, suppose I'm opening another browser. So suppose I am a student, I am not a teacher. My teacher has given me the game pin. So since I am a student and I have opened a browser, Google, you know, Chrome tab, new tab, I am now going to EduPlay, Educa Play and game pin. I go here and I click on game.educaplay.com. Now I don't have to create any account here. My teacher has given me game pin. I would enter and I'll say enter the challenge, and I'll be able to, this is asking my nickname. Now suppose my nickname is Rashmi and I write my nickname and say login. Now here I have the access to the same activity which my teacher assigned me. So this is the beauty. It is not asking students to share their personal information like date of birth or linking with email or forcing them to create an account. No, they just have a game pin which is given by the teacher and they can start the activity. Some people in the audience may ask me that this is coming for a challenge, the game pin. How to share an activity? I'm showing that as well. Let me come to my dashboard. So this is my dashboard. So this is my activity. So if I click on this activity, I come here and there is a share option here. So I click on share and then I have this button which is copy. So I click on copy and I can put it again in the chat window in my classroom, wherever I am doing it with my students. So I've put in it in. So I can simply share by clicking here. I have the options to share on the Google Classroom, Microsoft Teams, and other LMSs here also right away on my share button. I can simply copy. I can save it for future reference in the offline mode. That is also available. So these are the activities that are, these are the options that are available to me. Now I tell you one beautiful part of it. So as I told you that any activity that you decide to create, so these are the activity that I decide to create. Now suppose I am stuck somewhere, I don't know how to create a riddle, I have never created. So I go to new activity, I select riddle from here. The moment I would start to create my riddle, I would write the name of the riddle. Let's say it's a riddle about input output devices. Then I give a little description, maybe I write for middle school. And then I can specify the age group. So knowledge area is, let's say, computers, information and communication technology. I decide my age group. So this is the age group for which I'm creating. Then I click on next. So the moment I do next and I don't know how to watch create riddle, it gives me instantly a video. I can go to the video. Now see,
in order to create a new activity in.
So basically it would show you step by step. So like you, I am also an educator. So when I explore this particular platform, so far there are 23 type of activities that are available for me to create. But I have learned to create 7-8 of them. Every time I'm planning to create a new activity, I may not know all the steps. So what I do, I watch the video, which gives me step by step process. I watch that. I learn how to create a riddle and then I go about creating my own riddle. So it's not, you know, there's no problem if you are new to this platform. This option of having a tutorial for every activity is a beautiful part. You can learn instantly. You can instantly watch the video how to create
in a Juka Play. You must,
and then you can start making your own tutorial. This is one thing which I wanted to add on. Then you have a beautiful support center. So if you go to support center, these are small 2 minutes video. It says like how to use other people. Say for example, I have published a quiz on Eduka Play which has 20 questions. And you are a teacher, you found that in the while you were searching on a quiz on internet, you find my quiz. Now you feel that ma'am has made 20 questions, but my children, I have taught them the content related to 15 questions. 5 questions are useless. So what you can do is you can duplicate my quiz and delete those 5 questions. So that is doable. Then you have how to share activities and save results for all players. This is I'm going to show you. So these are small, small hacks that makes your life easier, which is available under the support center. So you can watch these quick video and learn about it. Then you have blog. So you have these whatever latest, you know, distinguished news or latest news, whatever update comes on the platform, that is available under the blog section. You can have them available to you here. You can watch whatever are the new updates that has come to this software. Now coming back to reporting part. So I told you in the beginning, the software has 3 facilities. It allows you to create any activity. It allows you to share activity. You can use other people's activity. For example, if I want to use other people's activity, so if I go here and I want to search, let's say, parts of plants. So I want to search this other people's activity, which I showed you earlier also. Now suppose this activity I found, this is match the column activity. So I'm liking this activity, but I feel that, you know, I need to do some changes. So I can hit this button and I say duplicate and create my own version. So I can duplicate somebody's resource. It would come to my repository. Then I can edit it and do the changes the way I want. So for example, I have not taught my children about cytoplasm. Rest of the thing I have taught. But ma'am, whoever has created this activity, they have given a question here on cytoplasm, which I don't want. I can delete this question. Now this is happening in my own version because I duplicated that activity. I can do that and I can save it. And then I can publish it as my own activity and share it with my students. So that will be my version of this particular activity.
Okay, ma'am.
Once I come,
we've got last 8 minutes left, and I've got a few questions to ask. So would you wrap up your explanation and then we'll begin with the question answer round?
Yeah. So I'm more or less Tanviji through. I wanted to show this one last thing, which is reports, which is very, very nice. So suppose you do and play an activity 5 times with your class, and what are your students' responses? So you can check them here. So for example, I created this activity and I did it 5 times with my class. I click here. It will give me, because I haven't done it once, the moment I would do, I would be able to get the statistics. So it is showing total plays 0, average time and average score. But if I would have done it with my student, I would have got the real-time statistics. What is my student's outcome on this particular activity? So reporting dashboard is fantastic. In the free version, we get reports of last 3 month activity. While in the paid version, you have options to retain reports of 1 year entirely. So this is what I wanted to, show in this particular demo. I am now open to questions. Please feel free to ask any questions that audience may have, and I'll be happy to answer.
Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am, for the explanation. And it's a wonderful app. It's a wonderful tool. And I'm sure all the teachers and parents, they'll be very happy to show it, to explore them with their students and children. Thank you, ma'am. Okay, so I wanted to ask that this entire screen you showed, it was in English, but we have got regional languages, foreign languages. So is it available in any other language apart from English?
So ma'am, we have these three options.
Okay.
So English is available, French is available. One more, I think this language is Russian or what? So three languages are available. I'm sure you are asking for the people in audience, those who are looking for Hindi option, that is not there.
Okay.
So three languages are there.
Okay. All right. And how frequently, ma'am, does this app get used by the teachers in schools?
So ma'am, as I said that I'm a classroom teacher. So more so during the pandemic when we were teaching online, in order to retain the attention of our students on screen, it is very vital that we do some of the activities. And when we create activities, we go to multiple platforms. So my previous year, I was using at least 4 to 5, tools. So if I was to do a video-based assessment, I may go to Edpuzzle. If I was to do a quiz, I would pick up Forms or Kahoot. But once I was introduced to this platform and I saw that all the activities are under one umbrella. So this has become my favorite tool. At least I can say that any educator who is familiar of this platform must be using it 3 to 4 times in a week to create classroom activities.
Okay. And ma'am, about the one of the games you showed, the crossword one, there was a timer in it. So is it possible that one can pick the time according to their choice, or the timer is fixed?
No, ma'am. It's absolutely, we can decide that was editable. We can set up any amount of time for any activity.
Depending on the age of the children, right?
Yes, depending on the age and the complexity of the questions that we would come up with.
Okay. So, ma'am, right now because of the COVID, everything is online. But once we open the schools, everything will get offline once again. So, is it possible that we can take the printout of these games and then circulate it in the class to each and every individual or student?
Yes, very much possible. My screen is loading. Yeah. So, if this activity which I made, for example, this plant cell or anything, I click on option and I have this option of download. I will get a hard copy of the activity. If it is match the following on the screen, the same way it will be printed on the paper and teachers will be able to use the hard copy also.
Okay. And is there any limitation on how many games can be created by one person in a free account?
No, there is no such limitation which was given on our homepage also. So when you come, it was written. I told you in the premium version, the benefits are in terms of you can set the privacy, like who can watch your creations. You can control the access. But the public library of resources is open for both free user as well as premium users. So on their home screen, it's written, it's absolutely free. And there's no limitation. So the tagline here says that you can, there's no limitation on the number of resources that you can build. It's stated over there.
Okay. But in the setting, one can choose that who can see your creation. So that means it depends on the teacher or the person who is creating the game, right?
Yeah. So I, as I said that the premium version allows us to do that. So if I click on premium, I showed you that three kind of premium packages are available. In the free version, once I publish, I cannot control, it goes to public library, it's accessible to all, which I said is a beautiful part. Like I'm using other teachers' resources, they should be able to use my resources also. But if I want to use the platform within the organization, not share with the rest of the world, I have to go premium, and then I would be able to control that only these people should have access to the resources created by this organization.
Okay, so that means in the public space, one can use each other's resources.
Yes, which is just a search away. You put the topic here and then you get all the resources which are created by other educators.
Okay, and ma'am, is there any security threat that the data might get leaked anywhere by the student side?
So ma'am, as I said that when the children just need to have game pin. So when they come to this platform, even if they don't have account, they need the game pin or the link to the activity, they would directly join. It just asks them if the teacher want the children to enter their name, then only they can enter the name. Otherwise, they can just join by an anonymous name also. So it is not forcing, the platform is not forcing the students to sign in using an ID or to give their date of birth or name. So it's absolutely safe. The account creation part is only for educators, and we are adults, we are not minors, so it should not be a problem.
Okay. And ma'am, games are of different categories. There are individual games, there are group activities. So can we create the games for groups as well?
Yeah. So for example, if you have divided your class into groups, so you create a challenge and you assign it to a group, you share the game pin with that group. So the platform can very well be used to create group based activities also. So that's absolutely not a problem. Individual activities as well as group activities can be easily created.
Okay. Thank you so much, ma'am, for sharing everything regarding EducaPlay. And it was wonderful how we can know, even have knowledge and even we can have fun simultaneously with this tool. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. It was my pleasure to be here and sharing this with the audience. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for all the viewers to watch this entire session. It was wonderful to know about EducaPlay, and even you can use this resource for the children around you. If there are children in your house, please recommend this tool, and you'll be surprised that it's going to be fun while playing these games. Thank you once again, and stay with us. Don't go anywhere, because upcoming next is another special program of our Sayog, Guidance for Mental Well-being of the Children. And the topic for discussion is going to be the art of effective communication. So if you have any questions, please raise through our channel NCERT Official. Thank you once again. Namaskar.